Welcome back to post-apocalyptic flower arrangement. Have I made that joke already? I don't even remember. Dolphin riders are basically the pole vaulting zombie of the pool. They jump over the first plant. It's rather annoying. What did I just get? Torchwood? And potato mine, I guess. You know, with the post-apocalyptic flower arrangement joke, the flower arranging thing, and I don't have a rake. Crap. I kind of wonder what kind of stairs you would get if you went for a job in a florist place and yada yada yada, and they're like, well, what experience do you have? And what school you went to? I'm assuming that, you know, that school is required for this kind of thing, for flower arrangement. I wonder what kind of look you would get if you said, oh, I beat Plants vs. Zombies. Get out. But I beat it. I didn't die. I didn't have my brains eaten. Get out now, or I'm calling the cops. But... Several minutes later, and, you know, the cops show up, and you get taken away. Actually, the, gentleman in the white coats would be more appropriate, wouldn't it? And just as you're leaving, scream back over your shoulder, I beat the minigames, too! I don't have the man orbs to do that myself, but I think that would be amusing. I didn't pick up snow peas. Oh well, torch what it is. I completed the mini games. Oh boy, that would be silly. Also, lately, I've been playing a lot of demos, just to see what they are, what various games are like. And overall, I'm rather disappointed. I mean, demos aren't anything new. I mean, think about it. Demos have been around for a long time. They're the thing of, you know, the person possibly buying this game is not sure whether or not they would enjoy it. So, I'm going to put out a demo so they can try it. And a lot of them are good. Like, you get a real good feel of the game, of what the game is going to entail, what you're going to be involved in. Is the gameplay fun for you? Will you enjoy it? That's the kind of thing that the demo is there for. And despite all of the years and years of video games, some developers still get it wrong. Massively wrong. I mean, I played one, I don't even remember what the game was, but the demo was like limited to 5 minutes, and the first like 3.5 minutes were cutscene. What good is that? Honestly, what good is that? That doesn't give me anything. Ugh. I mean, there's been lots of good demos, like really good demos. For instance, you know, how Doom did. They're like, okay, here is the first whole episode of Doom. See if you enjoy it. And Doom was wildly successful, and crap. I need a little bit more on this alley. Oh well, Torchwood's out. So yeah, there's lots of good demos. There's still lots of bad ones, though. I don't understand how they can still be bad. I mean, it's not new. I'm actually speaking of, I tried the new XCOM, I tried the demo for that, and, you know, I knew what I was expecting, because I had played the original XCOM. But it gives you a tutorial mission, that's fine, you know, how to play the game, that's fine and all, dandy, how to play my game, the game that we've created. Thank you! That's needed, that's necessary. But after the tutorial mission, it gives you it has you do some stuff, and then you choose which mission you're going to do right after that, and that mission's the last one. Guys, could you give me like, I'm not saying give me like 16 hours of play on your demo, that's a little bit much. But at least give me, you know, a couple of goes at it. You know, at least let me experience a couple of more missions, not just the one that I actually have control over. I mean, also, you know, speaking of good demos, Final Fantasy VIII had a good demo. As much as I don't like that game, it had a good demo. It gave you more than enough to realize, okay, do I want this game? And I thought I did, because it came on a little PlayStation demo disc. You had a significant portion to play through. Like, it took like an hour and a half or something. At the time, I didn't realize how bad draw magic would actually suck the fun out of the game for me. But it had it was late. It wasn't early on in the game either. It was late enough in the game that you could see what would happen. You know, what kind of abilities you would have if you're veteran to, you know, Final Fantasy, of course. No, but it gave a good gist of what was going to happen, and I don't have potato mine. Ew. This is bad. No potato mine. Well, crap. I didn't pick potato mine. See, what other kinds of good demos can I think of that I've played? There's also one of the 5-minute ones that I remember was on Xbox Live. I downloaded it and it played it for sat through cutscene, played for 45 seconds, and it's like, oh no, that's 5 minutes. Your experience is now over. What? Excuse me? What do you mean I'm done? I didn't even finish one fight yet, and you're saying I'm done? It's just not right. Again, it's not a new media. It's been around long enough that we should be getting this stuff right. It shouldn't be a problem, but apparently, it still is. Oi. Anyways, more post-apocalyptic flower arrangement. I have nothing else to talk about. That was pretty much it. Those two things. Are you going to die? No. Oh yeah, the tall nut replaces the walnut. It's slightly better. Slightly. Nice thing about it, the pole vaulting zombies can't go over them. That's probably the most important part. Do 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 do. Ah, what else can I talk about? Just the demo thing just irked me. I think they'd have it all sorted out and everything. But I guess things like that happen. Not too happy about it, as you can probably tell. I need to get spikeweed out too, since, well, there's zombonis. What else have I gotten? Other than torchwood, and you saw how fantastic that is. Brains! Oh, crap. Hopefully it doesn't fling a whole bunch of, things at me right yet. No zombonis? Really? I'm actually kind of amazed you guys haven't thrown a zomboni at me yet. Thank you, though! Really! I appreciate it. Not to mention, you can set up the walnut here, and just one spikeweed, and they'll sit there and continue to get hit by it. Need my repeaters out, though. Oh! No! Stop that. Don't like you. What is the gambling pay? 5,000? Not that I'd buy it currently. That's something that you really only worry about in survival, because you have so long to build up your build this up that it actually becomes useful. And that row is pretty much set. I still need to put torchwood on it. I hope you live long enough for. Keep guys from coming out so soon. Man, I'm hungry. I'm just hungry, hungry, hungry. I don't know what it's last few days I've just been like constantly starving. Does make a lot of sense. I don't know why it's like that. I mean, I'm not even gaining weight. I hope when I was younger, my metabolism was so high that I actually got tested for tapeworms because I was eating, you know, 6,000 calories of food every day. I'm not kidding, really. I was eating almost constantly, sleeping very little. They were actually worried that I might have a tapeworm or have thyroid problems or something that would mess up my metabolism and make it go. Is it the thyroid? It doesn't really. I think it's the thyroid. Manages your metabolism. But I also had a cat like that. The poor thing had horrible whatever with it. I think it's called the thyroid. I don't think the cat ever slept. And what do cats usually do? They sleep and sleep and sleep. That's what a cat does. But the thing would go absolutely berserk. We were keeping them in the cellar because, you know, it was wooded area and we had coyotes move back in. So we kept them in the cellar to keep them safe. And the cats learned how to open the door, kind of. Where they would whack the doorknob and sometimes they would get it to unlock. So that it was constant annoyance that that cat would be hitting that doorknob all hours of the day. I mean, all day, all night, just never sleeping. And eventually, you know, the kind of partial of the cat got it, the poor thing in operation. And I think it lived for 2-3 more years longer, but I mean, to have your own body turn against you like that. I mean, really, there's also the poor individuals that their immune system sees their body as, you know, the villain, as it were. And crap. Crap. Crap! This is... I really can't do anything about you guys. He's just gonna nom right through that because I don't have my squash. Oh, but yeah, that cat died a bunch of years ago. It lived to be like something like 19. Cats in my family always seem to live for a really long time. I think my other cat, her name was, I was talking about Shadow. That's the one that had the thing with its thyroids and had some really big problems with its metabolism. That was Shadow. The other cat, Geraldine, she was white and orange. Crap, what did she die from? I don't remember. It was... Oh, no, yeah, she had feline AIDS. That's what happened to her. Yeah, that's what happened to my cat. The dog that I had died when I had... I'm sorry about the depressing topic. The dog that I had, Sadie, lived a very long life, and when I was in 8th grade, woke up one day and we didn't see her, and she was always out and about, you know, over in her little area, just doing whatever dogs do. And woke up one morning and she wasn't around. So we go out, look in the doghouse, and the poor thing was like, she had kicked out the back of the doghouse, gone through the wood. I guess it was dry rotted. And was stuck. And this isn't how she died. We found her like that. Was it the night before or the night of? I'm sorry. This was when I was in 8th grade. This was a while ago. Let's kill you. I don't want to lose. No, lost it anyway. I think she was. That was the night before. I found her stuck, and the next day she died. You know, I'm assuming it was just. It might have been old age. It might have been something. I don't know. But enough of the depressing topics. Yikes. I started this episode all thinking of silly things and all that, and suddenly it becomes about the deaths of my animals that I've had. I mean, my animals all live long lives. They all lived a very long time. It's not like they didn't have a full life. I mean, I walked the dog, I played with the dog, didn't know any tricks or anything. It was just my dog, and played with it and whatever. I hope she was happy. You know? I would hope. You know, my cat, the cat dying was pretty bad. And also, the same year I lost my dog was the same year that I lost my last living grandparent. Let's just keep going with the depressing thing, shall we? I'm sorry. If you were having a bad day, I apologize. I really do. It's just the topic that came to mind. Yeah, Zombonis will just drive over everything. Doo-doo-doo, and you need to die. Get rid of that ice trail. You're not giving me enough things, game. Enough spike weed. I need more. More spike weed. Let's get rid of you. Doo-doo. I still got two waves to go through. Lily pad. No, that's not where I wanted it. Oh well. Well, this level's pretty much done. I think I have a little bit over coverage in the middle rows, though. You guys aren't even getting in the water, are you? You don't serve a purpose. Stop giving me squash. More three-peaters, please. Not the ideal place to put them, but I kind of need them out there. Come on. Three-peaters game. Give me more three... Actually, give me more walnuts. Please don't eat that. I hate you. Ah, I'm missing money. I need that. Just start blowing everything up. Whee! Blowing stuff up. Money! Oh, crap. That was dumb. Yeah, if you don't have... If you don't get rid of the ice, the toboggan zombies show up. And... The actual toboggan, or what, the thing, toboggan, takes a ton of damage, but at the end of the ice it breaks, and they all get out, but that's four zombies that you have to worry about. That's the wrong row. Stuff in the wrong place here. Oh yeah. Remember, what was level 2? Level 4 is also a night level. It is. Same as a push room, but for the water. Woo, that's it. That's enough of this part. I'm sorry about getting so depressing towards the end. I'm sorry, but you know, the animals that I had, I love them. They all lived long lives, and hopefully they were happy before, you know, the things that happened to them. I also, Sadie also had a thing with her eyes. She couldn't see out of one of her eyes, and but you know, nah, I'm sorry. I just got really depressing towards the end. Now I made myself sad. Until next time, I apologize.